Ladies and gentlemen, in the last two decades, hundreds of thousands of people have entered this country every year. Often we have no idea who these people are. We've never been given a vote on the issue of mass migration, and still none of the mainstream political parties are remotely interested in talking about it. The population of Britain has increased by 10 to 15 million in the last two decades. Anyone who voices their anxiety about this is likely to lose their job, forfeit their good name, or even be prosecuted. Anyone who dares to comment that Bradford looks like Islamabad, Southall looks like India, or Chinatown looks like China is called a racist. In other words, a very bad person. It's the left that calls everyone racist while discriminating against the native population and the working class. What, if not skin colour, is a black, Asian, minority, ethnic programme supposed to be based on? It is pure racial discrimination. Even commercial advertising has become a form of engineering. Advertisers are pressured to show the typical British family are of mixed race. In reality, just 3.45% of children born in Britain are from such families, as are my own children. So why is this happening? There are many reasons for this. Votes, money, profits, or the Marxist disruption of the nation state. Tony Blair said he wanted to rub the right's noses in diversity, and how he has succeeded. In places like Birmingham, the minority has become the majority. As we know from last week's question time, we're not allowed to say we're full up. We're not allowed to say health tourism is a big problem. We're not allowed to say we want our country back, and we're certainly not allowed to say that certain groups commit crime at a higher rate than others. We see fraud, acid attacks, rape and murder, but we're not allowed to comment from where the perpetrators come. Every single statistic on immigration attacks abuse or is viciously disputed. If we say house prices are massively higher because we've had 10 million new people who need a home, we are told we're being silly, that you're talking rubbish. Schools and hospitals full, council house lists without end, roads and trains chopped, public services failing, social security and housing benefits rocket ever upwards. But of course, it's nothing to do with the number of people. If we say migration lowers wage rates, we are shouted down. We're told by the left that it's simply not true. But we all know that if you have three people who want to buy a house and they compete against each other, the price goes up. And if you have 80 people who want a job, the pay goes right down. So as a result, we've had to force income levels up at the bottom by minimum wage controls, tax credits, in-work benefits, billions of pounds of which leave our shore every year through little money laundering operations in shops in Harrow and Blackburn. And let's talk about refugees. Only 6% of illegals who set foot on our soil are sent back. This is an open door invitation. As we saw last week with the Jamaican deportation flight, and they were not British nationals, if you were not given a mobile phone chip by the state, even if you had murdered a child, judges tried to stop you from being deported because your rights might have been infringed. Refugees have just been given the right to vote in Scotland. So who are these refugees? The politically persecuted? The destitute? The sick? Well, not exactly. Here is a typical example of an economic migrant. Hassan, 28, is earning a reasonable living in a paint shop in Ouagadougou. He's managed to save $5,000. His family decide that Aslan should try to come to England. He's been told that if you just set one foot in English soil, their judges, who fear to be called racist, will not deport you, and you'll be given lots of free stuff. Once Hassan has a British passport, his family tells him that he must immediately bring over a wife and start a family. Each child brings a British passport and the benefits that come with it. Entire villages have ended up in Britain by this type of chain migration. The government and the righteous left would rather the public did not know about Hassan and his fellow migrants from all over the world, the majority of whom fit this description. There are genuine refugees from war, displacement, famine, but as we know from Syria and the Christian Barnabas Trust,